wasnt.davi. He's harmless. He's just a gentle giant.
Yeah, but he's creeper.
He's highlighted away for the past 10 years.
He still scares me. That's why we're moving into the Furman Institute after all this time.
Ours is not to reason why.
So you did it anyway.
Hello, Dr. Marland.
I'll be taking this to the board.
Take it away, like Patricia. I'm the senior psychiatrist here, and I was only following orders.
Thank you. I'll be right.
Dutchie, watch your shoulder. Here's your breakfast.
Thanks, babe. Hello?
Where?
I'll be right there.
Morning, Jennifer. So, what's going on here then?
We've got two bodies. One male. One female. And one apparently abandoned vehicle belonging to the Alex DeLarge convalescent home from Craven. Reported to us by the gentleman in the van. DS Bauer's talking to him now. DC White's onto forensics.
Cause of death?
Come and take a look.
Bit nasty.
Yeah, Chief.
Go, boss.
You buy one, you get one free.
Well, obviously you can see both victims have been viciously beaten.
Red on you.
Has he had anything enlightening to tell us?
Didn't say anything. He pulled in for a piss and found him like that. I took his details in case we need to contact him.
What are these cameras?
The cameras are a no go. They're all just for show, Chief. All the samples on the way.
Good stuff.
So, where's our patient then?
This is a patient transfer sheet. We've got ourselves a driver. We've got a nurse. We're either missing a body, or we've got our first suspect. You, Sue, stay here. Liaise with Socko. You, come with me.
So where are we going?
We need to talk to whoever signed this. Here, you drive. I need to make a call. You tell me, these two dead members of staff and the missing patient a problem.
Missing patient?
Mr. August.
Auguste. Zane Auguste.
Whatever.
And two dead members of staff.
What's happened?
Carnage in a lay-by.
You've lost me.
We found one of your vehicles abandoned in a lay-by. And close by, two bodies, deceased, of whom we think are in your employment. And the patient that you authorised the transfer for is missing. So why don't you tell me a little bit more about this Mr. August?
Auguste.
Whatever.
Zane's never been violent. He won't hurt anybody. He's been catatonic for the past 10 years. He's never had to speak a word for the past 10 years. He's never been aggressive in any way.
Why then is he under your care?
Zane's lost his family under horrific circumstances, which caused the mental breakdown. He's been avoiding any emotion. It's as if he just dropped himself from the rest of the world.
Horrific circumstances.
It's all misfiring. I'm sorry, this is a bit of a shock. Did you see Duffy's dead?
Yes, and the driver.
This is awful.
Where's it being transferred to?
The Thurman Institute.
Isn't the Thurman Institute about introducing these type of people back into the community?
That's correct.
Then maybe it's them that should be talking to you about this.
I think maybe I should be talking to them myself.
Look, I can see this is all coming as a bit of a shock to you, and you've got a lot to sort out. We can catch up at a later date.
Take my card. I'm more than happy to help at any time.
You couldn't put a home address on there, could you? Just in case we need to catch you out of hours?
Yeah, of course.
We'll be in touch.
It's been catatonic for the last 10 years. Why the hell has he been reintroduced back into the community?
You need to get onto the Thurman Institute. Find out who made that transfer request. Get hold of Willie. Get into that file. We need to find out everything about this Mr. Auguste.
Auguste?
Whatever. Make it so.
Well, where are you going?
Home.
What for?
Afternoon delights.
Afternoon delight?
Blowjob. Unless you want to do it.
Fuck off.
Didn't say that last time.
The last time I was drunk. It was a Christmas party and I was having a bad time at home, and the last time was the last time.
You better take me home then.
You do realise I've had you for sexual harassment.
You can have me anytime, baby.
Thurman Institute and try and track down who requested that transfer. I'm just going to go over a couple of things with the S. Rogers. Get back to me if you come up with anything.
Good. Oh,
doctor.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh
my tongue to my king.
Furman's knows nothing about this transfer. They don't even know the same character is. And ditto to Mackay.
Okay, I'll get hold of Dutchie. And see where he wants me to go from here. I'll catch up with you later.
People at Furman didn't know anything about Zane's transfer.
And this page is missing from his file.
What are you packing in? She's delighted.
Someone's selling us porkies. Just hang on a sec.
I'll get you some pork pies out of the fridge.
Well, I think we need to speak to that Dr. Mackay again, don't you? Yeah. Okay.
Fancy to come out?
I'd love to, mate. We've got shitloads to do.
Do we have the lamb tonight, then?
No, not tonight, mate. I've got Hope coming over. Going to get a few bottles of the good stuff and probably get slaughtered.
Nice one.
I thought you were going to do the flyers for next weekend.
Nah, Lorraine's doing them.
Oh, right.
I'm done.
Ready to go. You play tomorrow, then?
Thank you.
This looked like a fucking enterprise.
Just been to the convalescence home. She ain't there. Yeah, we're at the address she gave us, and we spoke to a Mr. Lemon, but he's never heard of her. Yeah, I don't look around inside, but it seems as though he's telling the truth. It's a dead end. I'm gonna stick around here and knock on a few more doors. Come back round for me in a bit.
Okay.
And so the race has run. You ran hard and you won. It's time to have some fun again.
Thank you.
took you this long to come round? Found you ages ago.
Well, Craven is a small town, Mrs.
Miss Kiddo.
As I was saying, Miss Kiddo, Craven is a small town and our resources are very limited. We did get here as soon as we can, so what's your problem?
Well, it's my neighbour, Mr. Lee. I'm a bit concerned about him.
Why are you concerned about him?
Well, he came home last night around his usual time.
What time was that?
About 11:30, just finished watching Jeremy.
Jeremy?
Paxman, on Newsnight. I was just about to make myself a cup of tea before bed. He came home, I heard a bit of a commotion.
What kind of commotion?
A bit of banging, a lot of doors slamming.
Anything else?
No, not last night, but I used to go to his paper about 9:30, just as I'm watching Jeremy.
Paxman?
Kyle. And I've not heard his music playing this morning because he likes his music, does Stan?
Well, Miss Kiddo, I'll call in on Mr. Lee, but you've not really seen anything. And until he's been missing for 48 hours, we can't really do anything. He might just be doing something outside of his usual routine.
Yeah, but
I'm afraid that's all we can do. I'll leave you to your day. If you hear him, let us know. If not, just call us and we'll see if we can contact his family. But until then, I'm afraid that's all I can do, so good afternoon.
So, who do I contact then? Do I contact you?
Just ring the station.
Oh, right, okay, thanks.
Back for me.
Chief, I'm back at the Ellis the Large. Everybody's convinced that this transfer came from the Furman Institute.
Yeah, we already knew that.
Apparently, Dr. McCoy and Dr. Marlin had words.
I think we need to speak to this Dr. Marlin then.
Got Marlin's home address. Gonna try and track her down. Keep you updated, Chief.
Please, Doctor!
meanest I'd ever heard. Wave from a newsman. I dig the sound.
You were coming round here tonight.
Yeah, no, I'm taking off now, I'm on my way.
Well, I've just opened a bottle of wine, and if you don't hurry up, there's going to be none left for you.
And the better fucking happy. Hello? Are you still there? Hello?
Hold on, yeah, the dogs are going fucking mad. I'm going to have to find out what's going on with them.
Alright, okay, see you soon. Bye!
Yeah, alright, see ya.
I'm reporting to you from the scene of a group's...
Oh, nice, you finally make it.
Police have confirmed shit. That the body of a decapitated woman was found in the early hours of this morning here in Portsmouth. You walked up next to a human hair. While there is no known motive as yet, and police have no suspects, we at FNN can report that the victim is believed to be 18-year-old Jane Letterman. Better keep running. A massive investigation has now swung into force. With police interviewing friends, relations and acquaintances of the victim. The body was discovered in shrubbery in this local park. And while details are still very sketchy at the moment, keep tuned to FNN for all the latest updates on this.
What do you want?
fellas.
Usual,
is it? Aye, please. How's your Chloe then?
I'm fine,
actually. Not bad, can't complain. Looking forward to the ballet this weekend then.
Yeah, it should be good, yeah. It should be really good.
Nice one. Not bad. No Jake?
No, he's had to work.
Rick not with you?
No, he's here. He'll stay now tonight. Gonna open a few bottles of wine. I reckon they've been slaughtered.
He's still coming on the rally though.
Oh, he wouldn't miss that, I can tell you.
So what do you think of the flyer then?
Usually open by now.
Come on!
Hang on a minute. A call.
You've reached Craven Animal Sanctuary. Unfortunately, we can't come to the phone right now. If you'd like to leave a message after the tone, we'll get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you.
Hi mate, it's only me. You probably overstepped, so it'll be a good night and everything. Anyway, we're going for a kick around. Maybe catch you later. All right. Cheers, bud. Ta-da. Come on, mate.
Thank you.
Female in the bathroom that looks like she's been bludgeoned to death with a heavy object. This guy here, well, it's obvious.
You got the point?
Got well and truly screwed.
I'll do the jobs around here if you don't mind.
The interesting thing is, what's on his chest?
Activist.
I'm on it, boss.
Nice.
All right, Dutchie.
It's pretty straightforward, this one, boss. Been bludgeoned to death with a dog.
So why has she been bludgeoned to death with a dog?
I don't know.
It's not straightforward then, is it?
Could have just been a robbery, boss.
This is no robbery. This is bloody murder.
That's not your bar. Where's your bar? Come on, let's go find your bar.
More than one message on that machine. Has anybody checked
it? You've reached Craven Animal Sanctuary. Unfortunately, we can't come to the phone right now. If you'd like to leave a message after the tone, we'll get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you.
Hello? I've just found an hedgehog in a milkshake garden, and it looks really distressed. I'll phone back later. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Give it to me, will it?
Yo, Chief, you're not going to believe this. Got two more dead bodies down here. Craven playing fields. Yeah, no, I'm just on the road. Looks to me like father and son. Well, adult and kid. But the strangest thing is that the fella's got a newspaper clipping pinned to his chest with a branch.
I'll be right there. I need to know who those other messages are from. I need to know who he is. I want to know everything he's done. I want you to do the usual shit, door to door. Get it sorted. I need it done now. I need it done yesterday.
But what about the girl?
Straightforward with the girl. Wrong place, wrong time. Sim I need to know about. Make it so.
Whose is this pie?
It's Holland's.
Just like Vinnie Miller all over again.
Vinnie Miller?
Serial killer.
Is it true what they say about him?
About him?
Dutchie.
Depends what they're saying.
Heard he was pretty handy back in his day.
Pretty handy doesn't really cover it.
He was more than just handy. He was Commonwealth Light Heavyweight Champion.
Fucking Light Heavyweight?
Well, like you say, he was in his day. There's been a few pies and pizzas since then.
Commonwealth Champion, eh? You won't find looking at him.
He'd probably still be up there with the best, but he dislocated his shoulder, winning the title. He practically won it with one arm. He couldn't cut it after that. Shame, really, he was undefeated. He could have been heavyweight champ.
Yeah, champ.
Yeah. Fucking donut.
Donuts. Come get me some fucking donuts.
We'll make it so.
Oi, what's my line? You still fucking here? So, what do we know?
Victim one, Mr. Attenborough. He's got a record as long as his arm, dating back to his college days. All activist-related issues starting at college when he decided to let all the rats out of the lab. Followed by numerous breaking and entering, sabotage, criminal damage. You get the picture. Victim two, Mr. Withershaw. Prominent local businessman. String of small hotels, pretty much squeaky clean apart from one black mark. He has one record of criminal damage and trespass, and it matches a case on Mr. Attenborough's record.
So there's the link.
Definite link. The last call on Mr. Withershaw's phone was the message we found in the sanctuary answer machine. A call made shortly before the bodies were discovered.
But where's the link to this?
Maybe it isn't connected.
Oh, it's connected. The mess left at that scene, the mess left at these scenes, ain't no coincidence. We've just got to find a connection.
I've got something. First of all, Dr. McCoy, she was only in charge at Alex Allard for 8 months. Before that, it was a Dr. Scott who was closely connected with Mr. Zane Auguste in particular.
So, have we spoken to this Dr. Scott then?
Chance would be a fine thing. Dr. Scott decided to put a Desert Eagle Magnum to his head and decorate his office with a
suicide?
It would seem so. That's what the coroner's report said anyway. But I did get hold of this, the complete file on Mr. Zane Auguste. And that's not all. I've checked the case that matched on the two victims' criminal records. They were found guilty of breaking into a travelling circus in the animal enclosure 10 years ago, one of the last to still use live animals in the show. They were trying to free them and they were charged with trespass, criminal damage and breaking and entering.
Yeah, we know that.
I'm not finished. Zane Auguste was a clown that performed in that very circus. He discovered them that night. He tried to stop them and there was a struggle. The paraffin lamp he was carrying got knocked and it started a fire. Auguste's wife and daughter were also performers in the circus. And while he chased them off site, they tried to free the animals.
And they never made it out? Dr. McCoy said they lost his family in a tragic accident.
Worse than that, when he returned to the site, he had to stand and watch them burn. After that, he had a complete mental breakdown, and that's how he ended up in Alex DeLarge.
Hold on, I don't get it. If they killed Auguste's wife and kid, why are they not still banged up?
That's just it, they never got banged up. A trial found them guilty of all the trespass charges, but ruled that the fire was never directly started by them. It was ruled as accidental death, and they walked away with community service and fines.
British justice, eh?
So, Auguste is dishing out his own justice?
That's how it seems. He's not finished.
What do you mean?
There were 4 people that night charged with breaking and entering. 2 of them are dead, and 2 of them are still out there. We've got the address for one of them. Paul Glover, landlord at the slaughtered lamb in Craven. The other's Lorraine Frost, but she's since remarried and changed her surname, still trying to get an address for her.
Well done, honey pie.
Can I help you?
Hi, are you Lorraine Frost?
Was, and Lorraine Pegner.
Would it be okay if we came inside to speak?
About what?
Zane Auguste. You have heard Zane Auguste. He's escaped from Alex DeLarge care home.
What? No. No, I've not heard.
Can I come in so we can talk?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, thank you.
Ben Doble wishing you a good night. Now it's the news with Hugh Janus.
Our headline tonight. Police in Craven are still looking for Zane Auguste, who absconded during transfer.
What's up, Dad?
Oh, don't worry about it, love. It's all right. Just get everyone out. Let's go. That's all.
What are you doing?
Don't worry about it. It's steady now. Let's just get rid of everyone. Let's get this place closed up for tonight, will you?
We need to get everyone out.
Why are we closing? What's going on?
Nothing's wrong. Just do as I asked. Just come out because we need to get off.
Yeah.
he's going to make you pay for what you did to his family. What you did to my family. You're going to suffer like he suffered. But never mind. You've been justice to all of you. For what you did to me. For what you did to my sister. To a strong position, to take over from Dr. Scott, to gain his trust, his love. Making my way into his affections, climb the ladder. He's recommending me to take over from him when he retired. You've got away with it for long enough.
Unusual.
Oh shit. Too late. Gone.
we've got a fire down here.
Okay, stay calm. You're stupid. Saying, is it? Look, I know about your wife and kids. I don't know how angry you must have been. But that was them. It's not us. I'm trying to help you. Just put the knife down.
Jen? Jen?
Go after them!
No! Jen, I can't leave you! I can't leave you, Jen! Jen! Oh, God! I can't leave you, Jen. Jen, you know I love you, don't you? You know I love you.
Ditto.
Jen? Jen?
Thank you.
This is for my sister.
It's over, Zane. It's over. Please, Zane. Stop this. That's right. Give me the gun.
Hey, boss.
Talk.
You got me pretty good.
You're gonna be alright, mate.
We both know that ain't true. It's too late for me.
No, it's not.
You're yeah,
be
go.
Right. I can't.
Go! We'll get it, champ. Oh, clown. I fucking hate him. Oh.
Island. Yeah, got an officer down. I need an ambulance. I need medical assistance. Straight away. I need some backup. 21 Lovell Lane. Pursuing the suspect into Westford Woods. Make it fast.
I know you not for me to say. I only watch and pray that you will find your way again. I touch with